Hello everyone. My name is Stefan and I'm a transformation expert and AI researcher. Today, I want to take you on a journey to discover how artificial intelligence transforms our lives and makes us limitless. But before we do that, let's have some fun about AI. Have you ever met artificial intelligence? I always have to smile when I see pictures of artists that try to create a very natural, human, realistic view about artificial intelligence. Now, look at that sexy robot right here. I just have one question. What is she doing? Stretching? Yoga? I think it's almost certain that a robot would never need to stretch. It would probably just ask for some oil. So, what I want for this talk is that when we walk out of here, we have a more realistic and better view about artificial intelligence. Therefore, let's ask the founder of the word artificial intelligence. John McCarthy coined the term artificial intelligence in 1956, so already 60 years ago. For him, artificial intelligence is the ultimate effort to create a program to solve problems, to achieve goals in the world like we humans. So we have a program, we have a problem, and we have a goal. The problem here is A, what is a goal? And B, what is a problem? Both are very subjective things, right? For you, it might be a problem to calculate the square root of 2019. A computer can do that operation 10 billion times per second. For you, it might be a goal to get rich and to live a healthy and long-lasting, happy life. AI has no consciousness about what is happy, what is rich, or what is a long life. So, let's look at this picture here. What do they both have in common? The similarity between both these four photos is that the whole computing power that was necessary to take human species for the first time on Moon equals the computing power of that basic calculator. Impressive, right? A device that we all have had in our hands and that cost approximately $25. So, what device do we have all here with us now, in that very location? Correct, it's a smartphone. The computing power of that mobile device is around 3 billion times more than that very basic calculator. So my question is, why aren't we on the way to Mars yet? I personally think it is because we waste too much energy in fighting against each other instead for a common goal. Therefore, I want to encourage you, use the devices you have at hand smart. It is called smartphone because it's meant to be used smart, not to play Candy Crush or Tetris. But let's continue our journey and let's look at some more applications about artificial intelligence. Like humans, AI already can see, hear, smell, taste, and touch. It already can read, learn, and speak, and write. Some of these things already at a way higher and faster level than we humans can do it. Let's look at some applications. For example, artificial intelligence can be used to get huge amounts of money. When applied to the history of markets, artificial intelligence made an annual return of 73% annual return of investment. And to be honest, it works best when humans go crazy. Like, for example, during financial crisis in 2008. In that year, artificial intelligence would have made an astonishing return of investment of 681%. Computer games. Who of you remembers his early days in his chess career? I remember mine started when I had chess pre-installed on my Windows 2000 computer. But it was my least favorite game. Why? Because the computer always beat me with moves that seemed to be so easy, but I could not foresee them. Today, AI is much more powerful than just beating humans in chess, and it beats human players in, for example, strategy games like StarCraft or first-person shooters like Counter-Strike. How about car driving? I think AI application in car driving is one of the most famous applications of artificial intelligence right now, and we are almost close to the finish line of implementation. In fact, the car manufacturer Tesla announced back in July that they will give their cars a fully self-driving software update till the end of this very year. I know it sounds a little bit crazy to see a car driver reading the newspaper behind the wheel, but when we look at the statistics of car driving accidents, AI is actually good for us. Statistics say that 94% of car driving accidents are due to a human error. I personally feel much more safe to know that many accidents are off the road. Medical analysis. AI identifies cancer better than doctors do. For example, a non-radiology physician recognizes cancer from CT scans with a chance of 60%. Artificial intelligence can do the job with 98%. Who of you remembers the hard task of translating a whole page of text from one language into the another back in school? Huge work, right? Artificial intelligence, or Google, translates already today more than 100 billion words per day. A human translator achieves a rate of 400 to 600 words per day. So for one human to translate all the words Google can translate in just one day, a human translator would need like 27,000 years. And how about shopping? Who knows that section on Amazon, like, recommended for you based on your previous shopping experience? Artificial intelligence makes a huge impact on online web service and shopping. And economists say that artificial intelligence accounts for more than 30% annual extra revenue for Amazon. Now, let's take a look at this picture with a room full of secretaries. Back in 1950, the average CEO had no more than 3 to 5 secretaries. Today, a CEO manages himself completely without one, or just has one assistant. So that raises the question, do we have to worry about our jobs? Generally speaking, no. Because when we look in history, innovation always also created some jobs, more than it replaced. But there will be a time of transition, and we humans must be open and adapting to change. And change will happen, with or without you. I saw what you wrote on the letters down in the center here, and some of you connected actually the word limitless to the word fearless. I think that's a good idea, and the connection could be there. So I brought you a list of skills that are demanded right now, and a list of skills that won't be demanded anymore in 2022. I think it's more valuable to look at skills here. You might have already recognized like an article or a news that said like, this job will not be there in the future. This work will be replaced by machines. Now, when you look at it, there's one skill showing up in both tables, and this is like coordination and time management. So if you're interested in that right now, I would rather not go for that for too long in the future. And there's actually a more important question, which is the trending skills for 2020. I think what's important to see is like analytical thinking and innovation stays up top all the time. Active learning and learning strategies goes up, and so does creativity. But the more important question I have here is, or the challenge is, don't think about how smart you are, but think about how are you smart? And I also made a list of human skills that might be a competitive advantage in the future. So this list now is like the ultimate human resources we have. It's creativity, decisiveness, passion, dream, honesty, sincerity, love. So these skills probably machines will never have, even if we try hard. And to be honest, I would not worry about my job, but rather worry about something that is called dark AI. AI is a powerful tool, but in the wrong hands, it can also create massive damage. And I'm very happy that the community of researchers about artificial intelligence is quite open and open-minded, and they have good work ethics. But I also know there are governments and there are militaries that have rather unethical goals. But let's continue with some more positive applications. What can you see in this picture? Nothing, right? Well, AI can, and actually, AI is pretty good with pictures. So here comes the defiltering, and one more, and AI can see that. And how about that? Who of you likes cleaning his apartment? I don't. And for sure, artificial intelligence has an answer to that repetitive tasks. And one question that came up in your youth, probably, what is a superpower you want to have? Well, it might be not first on the list, but artificial intelligence, with the help of Wi-Fi, can see through walls. And walls are a perfect transition to my clothing. One of my favorite quotes comes from the astronaut Alexander Gerst. When he was in the International Space Station, looking down on planet Earth, it was during the ongoing conflict between Palestine and Israel. And he looked down on our beautiful planet Earth and said, "I don't see any borders from here." In the end, technology is possibility and a tool. What is simple paint without the creative artist? It is not what technology can do, but what you can do with technology. Therefore, I think for artificial intelligence to be limitless, first, we need to be limitless. Thank you.